guys, Lina Khatib Interiors, Lina Khatib from Lina Khatib Interiors, interior designer. I designed this bathroom a while ago in 2015. I said, let me show you what I've done. It's a little bit on the modern side. So previously I showed you more traditional projects. Today is a very modern bathroom. So I'm gonna show you a before picture while the remodeling of the bathroom. I took this picture. I wish I took a picture before like we even start. So I took a picture of the construction of it. And this is how the bathroom looked during construction. So we got it all the way, floor to ceiling, all drywalls are down. We did the plumbing, electrical, tiling, and painting, of course. In this is the bathroom. This is how it looks. It's a really tiny bathroom. So I'm gonna show you from the outside. What I did is very modern vanity, and under cabinet lighting, if you see, there is under cabinet lighting and very modern vanity with a vessel sink. We call this kind of sink a vessel sink, and very modern also cubicle design faucet. And porter mirror, very like seacoast oriented porter mirror, and very modern lighting with shades. What I did in this bathroom is really tile all the way, floor to ceiling. I liked to incorporate the concrete look of this bathroom. Concrete material is really very modern material usually. And I love concrete, especially for the floor. I like it for the walls too, but it's gonna be very industrial if I put it on the wall. So I put it on the floor. What I chose is 36 by 36, 3 feet by 3 feet, actually 24 by 24, I'm sorry, 2 feet by 2 feet, concrete imitation porcelain tile, half inch thick. I did it, it looks like concrete the floor, but actually it's porcelain tile. So I'm gonna show you the tile with minimal grout. That's the tile flooring. Very minimal grout, 1/16 of an inch grout only to make a flawless slab looking flooring of a floor, of concrete floor. And this is the walls. I chose very ornate, I will not say ornate, it's a bit wavy. Wavy kind of tile from Tile Plus and Natick. Now I'm doing an ad for them. So I did it all the way floor to ceiling, and again here on the wall, floor to ceiling all the way to the ceiling. And I did an accent wall where the vanity is. I did marble, onyx marble. So I did have this onyx marble previously, and I said let me use it, and I use it for this bathroom. And you know what I chose for colors for this bathroom is all gray. Concrete is gray, so which is in style, by the way. In style right now. So I chose concrete looking tile, if it's for the wall or the floor, all of it porcelain again, very half inch thick porcelain. And because it's all gray, I wanted to accent it with a color. So I chose the vanity wall to have this color, which is like honey yellow finish onyx. Onyx is a beautiful transparent marble, by the way. If you put lighting behind the onyx, it's transparent. You can see that the lighting filter through. So, but here I put it all the way against the wall, as you see, all the way against the wall with white grout, floor to ceiling again, porter mirror, lighting with two shades, very modern. Again, gray walls, wavy wall here, all the way floor to ceiling. Concrete imitation flooring tile, under cabinet lighting, very modern gray vanity, vessel sink vanity, and that's it. That's the bathroom. Let's talk a little bit about, I have a glitch here. Let's talk a little bit about plumbing. For toilet, I like Kohler. Kohler is not only a good brand name of plumbing fixture, it's also very it has good flushing system, and it's very hygienic. It's made, they incorporate in the manufacturing porcelain of it some kind of material to make it very easy to flush and very easy to clean. So I recommend color all the time beside Toto. For the sink and the faucet, so our we chose very modern vanity. It's called a vessel sink. What I mean by that, a vanity, and the sink is sitting as a the bowl sitting on top of the countertop of the vanity. I would not recommend this setting except for a powder room. This is a powder room. As you see, there's no bathtub, there's no shower. It's a powder room. There's just a toilet, sink, mirror, lighting, and tile. I love the, before we move to the tile, let's focus a little bit on the vessel sink. Because it's a powder room, I like to incorporate vessel sink. It's more like interesting and not as common as we use it for regular master bath or guest bathroom with a shower or tub setting. So talking about also the tile, I love if the customer can afford to have the tile all the way from floor to ceiling, especially if there is tub or shower. It's really very hygienic and more clean, easy to clean, and it looks more neat, and it brings texture to the walls than regular paint. If you're gonna choose paint, has to be moisture resistant paint, especially if there is tub or shower from the steam. You need to use paint, moisture resistant paint. What else? That's it. That's the bathroom. Per code, per Massachusetts code, we have to have a fan, even if it's a powder room. So we're gonna show, we chose a Panasonic fan, which is in the ceiling. So you cannot, not every state, I don't know if you see it. Yeah, you can see it now. So not every state has this fan, this code, Massachusetts code. You have to have a fan, even not only in a bathroom that has a shower or a tub, you have to have a fan in a powder room. But this doesn't apply to any state. So again, I'm gonna show you a last picture. This is the bathroom, very small, very tiny. It was got floor to ceiling, completely redone, and it looks beautiful. This is, again, the bathroom. I'm gonna close the door. Let me see if I can fit, because it's very tiny, tiny bathroom. These are the walls, this is the door. This is the onyx beautiful wall with the vanity, with the mirror, and this is, again, tile, wavy tile with a window, and we finished the bathroom. This is it. Lina Khatib Interiors, interior designer.